Hi, I'm Saina Ink, and today we have a special video. This part of the botanical collab that Lana put this together on the Discord server. So we have 7 artists, including myself. We have Diana, Lee, Dan, Sterling, Boxer Paint, and of course Lana. So please enjoy the video and go check the all of the wonderful paintings that are available. They're all botanical themed, so there is a lot of beautiful flowers. So for the painting part, I decided to use some masking tape because I want to really clean edge between the poppy and the background. For background, I wanted to go this bokeh out of focus effect, same that is in my reference photo. Reference photo is taken by me. I wetted the whole paper and just like dabbed the color a little bit there. And I used different greens. I think at this point I had rosa color colors in use. And when that background was fully dried, I just removed the masking fluid. And that's something that you really should be careful when you're using masking fluid. Wait, the paper is completely dry. I think I had like coffee or dinner or something like when I let it dry, because it will rip out the paper. And we also have sadly missing clip because I forgot to push record when I came back. I put the initial layer on the poppy for the purple. And then I started to just like define a little bit of the petals. I want to... First, I was thinking to keep it really realistic and soft, but at some point I noticed that my reference photo wasn't good for that because it was quite low resolution. Focus wasn't quite off there, and also there was really like this little kind of blurred look I didn't like. At this point when I was painting, I really started like those really strong edges, like those little spikes and stripes you see on the poppies, because poppies petals are, they're like crepit. So I find that really fascinating, and I will communicate that more in my painting. So at some point I decided to stop, use the reference photo, and just go with like my vision of it. I started to choose the colors. I went with the quinacona purple with the schminke, and I think I also have some magenta and I think manganese violet. And I was first going to drive away from the manganese violet because it's granulating color, but then I decided that I will try that out, because you will see later I do something I usually don't do. I add wet white, which like tone down the granulation a bit and make it look more like soft. And here I started to add the shadows, and I wanted to really bring out that 3D effect of the poppy and really that like cup shape. And just watching where the petals go and which petal is casting shadow over to which other petal. So more like structural work here. And I was just going with the minimal details here. At this point I could still choose to go with the realistic route or choose something different. And I actually ended up choosing something different, which is really not common for me. I usually go with the realistic way, but this time I decided that this painting, since it's a really small scale, it's something that would benefit a little bit different approach, because my reference photo wasn't that good. It didn't have enough contrast. It felt like really like soft, and didn't have the right feeling I was looking for. So I decided that I will at some point put the reference photo away and go just with the painting. At this point I felt that I had enough paint on the paper, so I could like adjust the painting according to what the painting needs and not so much what is on the reference photo. One thing was I wanted somehow gradient on the spots. I want them to be a little bit darker on the middle than they are on the edges. Even if reference photo, they are really crisp and almost like one solid color. And that's how they actually look in real life. Also, I decided that I will move the stem of the poppy more for the left, so it like aligns with the center. I don't know why it's on the reference photo, a bit weird angle, and it makes it look really, really weird. And in the painting, it looks even worse. So I decided to move that a little bit. And because I had a new watercolor set, and there was titanium white, and it's really new paint for me, I decided I want to try it out, because I felt that the edges of the petals were went too dark, and it was like a little bit blending with the background. It felt like it needed to be a bit lighter. I took the titanium white and also white, used it quite liberally on the edges, and say like blend it a little bit towards the middle and make these tiny, tiny marks here. And then I really got this idea of having these little marks and like blending the whole thing, just having those little lines intersecting each other. And I actually really like how it ended up looking. It's really way from the reference photo, But at the same time, it's have that bobby feeling, having those like a little bit crinkly pedals there. So I think it's working out really well, and it was really nice to try out something new I haven't been trying before. The other white was, it went down quite opaque. It went lighter when it dried, but it was actually quite a nice feature because I could see it better when I applied it. But at the same time, this one's so strong as using like something like white gouache. And also Flutter Sheen, it's really matches for what I had in the watercolor. So it was like quite nice tool to use. I also a little bit fixed it on the center though, because I felt it was like dropping a little bit too on the like shadows there and didn't have any highlights. Then I made some final touch-ups on the background because I felt that the background has dried so light that the bobby will get darker, and I wanted the background to be darker. So I added some of the chromium oxide green here to make it a bit more darker. After darkening the background, I decided I want to have more blend the inner parts of the bobby towards the outside, and I used the same type of the blending I used outer ring. So I used just small lines that like represent of the crinkly part of the petals and like the crepes. So I think that's tied up really nicely together, especially the edges of the petal tied to the middle of the flower. So I think it's look more coherent because those lines go towards the middle. And I like that it's like almost brings out that abstract type of painting to the like botanical realistic side. So it's like mixed together. It still look like a poppy, and I think everybody like recognize it. But at the same time, it doesn't look like exact copy of the reference photo I had. And it has a little bit of more of that painterly look. I also had a little bit more cooler purple on the shadows there. And here I was adding last steps, like a little bit darkening the background and adding a bit more of those blobs on the lower left side because I want to be balanced. And there was actually the accident, sadly, isn't on the video, but I will soon see show how to fix it, because when I was removing the tapes, you can see there's two rows of masking tape. One of them is taping the paper on the board, and other one is just like preserving that white line. And when I was removing the inner tape, I actually rip off the both of top corners of this piece. So there was really not so nice mark on the paper. But I found way to recover it and make it almost invisible. Here you can see the damage I had on the paper, and I took regular, I think it's polished stone, amethyst, and I just go and rub it really gently on the surface that is damaged. It has a little bit of tooth, of course, because it's stone, and it's just a little bit of irregularities, so it matched quite well with the texture. Of course, I couldn't completely preserve the texture because it's like from the mold the paper is made, but it was much better than it was before, and it's almost like disappear. So if you don't, I think nobody would notice that there had been that kind of damage if I would tell it. But if you have like a polished stone or agate stone or agate burnisher, that would work really well on the like smoothing out the edges of, like edges that you have been ripped with the masking tape. And thanks for watching. Here is the last shot and some close-up of the painting. Because I use some of the granulating colors, there's quite a bit of texture on the poppy, and I actually like it, that like almost vintage feel on it. So thank you very much for watching, and I hope you go watch other collab videos. There's playlist made for them, and see what the other artist in this collab has been doing. So bye.